whatever, yeah. Future, yeah. I'm always out here moving, and what's up with that? Made a trap with the rubber balloon, man, what's up with that? Oh, yeah. Ain't never ever seen a spawn, man, what's up with that? What's up with I used that? To feel like a groom, man, what's up with that? What's up with Gary, yeah, I tell an angel on me. But be prepared, the devil came for me, came. There's blood diamonds in the field, and they going up, yeah. I've been back, deep in the rain, and going back to the back.
I ain't never had shit, what's up with that?
All right, guys. All right, it's another bloody, bloody day in the crypto market, all right? Today is Tuesday, June 26th. Market cap, $244 billion. The other day was $259 billion. So as you can see, it's just a massive drop of nearly almost $15 billion. We're talking about in one day. Yeah, it's, you know, welcome to crypto world, right? I mean, you know, this is, if you see something like in the stock market world, oh man, you know we're hitting recession. But in the crypto market, this is very, very normal, all right? So a lot of people who came from the stock market world, you know, those are what they call those FOMO, F-O-M-O, fear of missing out. That's what the acronym stands for. So those folks came in from the stock market and invested in, you know, Bitcoin and Ethereum and all that, and then they can't handle this. They can't handle the volatility of the market. You know what I mean? It's some people can have a heart attack and die trading in the crypto market with the way it moves. You know what I mean? So you got to be strong. You know what I mean? You got to know why you in this market to begin with. If you came here for the money, then you know, and then you didn't get the money, it's not a good feeling to go to sleep to, you know. But and I hope people are strong and, you know, hold on to their all their coins and don't sell at a loss. You know, I just don't, like I said, I don't want to see anyone lose their money, all right? So anyway, just want to thanks everyone for subscribing to my channel. I got 201 subscribers now, which is good, I guess. You know, I mean, it's not like I'm making money, so if y'all like my video, y'all want to I watch some informative or fun review on coins and stock, subscribe to the Coin King channel, all right? So that we all can, you know, share the, if you share the same interest as me, you know, this is the channel for you, all right? And I'm not one of those guys that read charts, okay? I'm not going to bug y'all with reading charts and then trying to educate you and trying to scam you, because like I said, first and foremost, all right, I'm not a financial advisor. I'm just a reviewer, just like a movie critic, you know what I mean? So I just review coins and stock, and you know, I invest in stock as well, so I have money in this market and in the crypto market. So but I am not by any means your financial advisor, so you know, consult with your financial advisor if you have any, okay? If you know, Google something or research on your own, all right, before you throw any money on anything. And lastly, I'll only invest what you're willing to lose. Don't go nuts on it, all right? So anyway, back to the coin market. I don't want to, you know, lecture y'all and stuff. So, all right, so all bloody red today, all right? And I'm going to be buying some few coins, but not massively, not a lot. You know what I mean? Like I tell y'all, this is a great, like, it's like a Black Friday deal every day now, you know, the past, I mean, since January, you know what I mean? Had I known it was going to be crashing this hard, I probably would have waited. But you know, like I said, you don't know. I'm not a fortune teller, so we don't know. But right now, because the market is so red, I think the best thing to do for me personally is I'm just going to scoop up only coins that is like quality coins that I think is going to go somewhere in 2 years from now. All right. And I said this in many of my videos. All right. I don't invest in garbage coins. Okay. And I mean, well, I don't want to say that. I mean, I have some that I kind of like think it's garbage that I don't even know why I did it. And I'm pretty sure I'm going to break even and make my money back, but I'm not going to get 100x. I don't think so, you know. But if for people who want to trade coins and will like want to be, you know, like less risky, and they don't want to, you know, don't want to lose money, all right? No one wants to lose money. But as far as like the lowest risk coins are the top 100. Seriously, the top 100. These coin here or top quality coins. If you own any coin in the top 100, you should never sell even if it's red like this, because when the market hit the $1 trillion, all this is going to run and you're going to make a lot of money. I mean, you're going to make a lot of money, but you won't make like 100x on some of these, like especially Bitcoin and Ethereum and let's say Stellar and Cardano, you may. EOS, that's what they call it. This is very hyped up. So this could actually, you could make like maybe 50x, I'm thinking, when the market pick up. You know what I mean? So China's betting that EOS is going to be huge. They said it's going to take over Bitcoin basically in the next few years. NEO, you'll probably get like around maybe 20, 30x when the market picks up. You know what I mean? So it's $30. It's insane. I don't think it's ever been this low. I think when the ICO, I think it came out at like around, the lowest was like $8 last year, and then it shot up to $48. You know, that was crazy. Zelica, this is a position I have, Zelica. I may actually load up a little bit more Zelica and Ncash. I'll probably get some more Ncash because I think Ncash has a bright future. Zelica has a bright future. And I talk about Helbiz. You know, I have enough Helbiz, which is this here. All right. This thing in tight. I have enough Helbiz. I'm not going to get any more position in this because I think it's a little bit risky on this with the technology, that even though it's a breakthrough technology that they have, or like a, it's kind of like Uber on steroids. I think it's just a little bit, kind of risky with the ideas. Somebody's texting me, probably on the, Social Wall Street. Someone's probably texting me, want to know some information, I guess. I'll respond later. But anyway, Helbiz, look at this. This is a good deal if you don't have any position. Circulating supply, only 547 million. That's really low. I mean, it has potential to run, but the only risky part is the technology behind it. It's a fantastic technology, innovative technology, but I don't think, I'm not sure the whole world is ready for an Uber on the blockchain. Maybe this technology they have may be worth a lot of money. So I have enough position that I'm not going to be adding any more on Helbiz. I'm going to be getting more in cash. Nucleus Vision, that is, because I think this is it's gonna run when the market pick up, because it's one of the most talked about cryptocurrency, and like I said, Tim Draper, the multi-billionaire, has a stake in it, and also Tim Draper has a stake. I may actually consider it's a company called Data Wallet. Okay, damn, my internet is slow today. Oh, geez. Anyway, it's called Data Wallet, all right? And it's, oh man, it's back to 3 cents now. I might actually get some more of these. Data Wallet. Tim Draper, the multi-billionaire investor, has a stake in Data Wallet. And look at this, circulating supply of 390 million. That's insane.
Yeah. Moon lover.
What in the world?
Yeah. Moon lover.
Oh, yeah. What is this? Oh, sorry. Sorry. Oh, my God. Gosh. I'm sorry, I had a Spotify running earlier. I made it obsessed with this Superfly soundtrack. I hate the movie though, but I love the soundtrack. But anyway, what's up with that? That's my favorite song off the album too, aside from Come Show My Chains Some Love. But anyway, back to Data Wallet. All right, guys. 3 cents, I might actually get some position in this, because this is a steal here. I bought this thing at 2 cents and I didn't sell. I have like a few thousand of these. It ran from 2 cents to 10 cents. I have like over 5x and I didn't sell. So it crashed back down. Like I said, I didn't know what the future holds. I didn't know it was going to crash back down this low, but now I know. So I may add more Data Wallet. All right. So, but I'm going to go over right quick. How many minutes do I have? Okay. I have a few more minutes that I can record this. All right. So anyway, I'm going to go over ones that I think has a potential again, all right, in this top kind of market where it's a steal, all right? Stellar, this is the people who founded, or actually part of the Ethereum people. They came on board to do this. Or is it the other way around? Yeah, it's the other way around. I apologize. Stellar is from the team for Ripple. They came and start Stellar, and then Cardano, the founder of Ethereum, came over and create Cardano at 12 cents, guys. Oh Jesus. This is so cheap. It's ridiculous. This thing was like almost $2 in December. Both of these, Stellar almost a dollar. This Cardano almost $2. Okay, Tron. I am seriously, you know what? I may have to forfeit some of what I mentioned earlier and get some more Tron, because I think Tron has a bright future. I think Justin Sun is a visionary leader. Even though a lot of people say, oh, Justin Sun is always on Twitter just promoting and pumping Tron. But guys, if you think about Tron, all right, if you think about Tron and the idea behind it, they just broke away from Ethereum now, okay? It has become its own coin, all right? So there's so many things that Tron is doing. You can go to their website and read more on it, but it has a high surveillance supply, but the potential of growth for Tron, I think, is going to be huge. I think Tron is going to be one of the top 10, that's going to stay in the top 10 in 2018 and 2019, because at first I was doubting it, but the more I look at it, you know, the more I read up on it, I think Tron is going to be one of the major player. And the name just kick ass, you know what I mean? I just love that name, Tron. I mean, because it reminds me of that Disney movie, right? So, and Justin Sun is, he's the protege of Jack Ma, the founder of Alibaba. So you never know what's going to go on, right? So anyway, that's one that I'm going to be holding on to, all right? And I mean, I'm going to be probably adding a little bit more to my position, because if I don't get more Tron, I might regret it later on. You know what I mean? So, but anyway, I'm going to go through all these. These are like a higher price. I don't play with coins over a dollar, because I don't expect I'm going to get a lot of return on it. I'm looking for like 100x when the market go to $1 trillion. Icon is $1.48. Like I said, I don't have position in this, but this is going to be huge too. I think it's going to be in like, $20 to $30, I think Icon will be. And Zilliqa too. I think Zilliqa will hit a dollar. It will hit a dollar to $2. It probably hit potential to hit $3, Zilliqa. It's too much stuff going on with them, all right? Verge had a deal with Pornhub. Jeez. I don't know why people bash them on Verge, because they have a deal with Pornhub as the payment method, all right? People watch porn. It's like, the porn market is worth more than movie industry, all right? So I don't see what the problem is. They accept digital currency through that site. I mean, it's just a payment, right? People want to make money. I mean, I don't understand why people are bashing on Verge because of that, you know? They just accepting payment through them, all right? I don't understand that. It's like using MasterCard or Visa. They accept Verge now. I mean, that's pretty cool. I mean, I don't care if it's a porn market. It's just, the business is they trying to make money, right? So I don't want, anyway, enough of that. Moving on, Bitcoin Private, $11. Wow, Bitcoin Private. This is crazy, 11 bucks. This thing was like 60-something like a few months ago. Wan Chan, that's another safe one right here. Ooh, $2. Ooh, Wan Chan, that's crazy. Oh, man. Walton Coin, people talk about it, $6. Nope. Nope. IOST token, 2 cents. Insane. Insane, guys. Why don't you add more? I know that guy Crypto Love, he has position in IOST. So anyway, Red Coin, this is a kind of like a video game. It's kind of rewards coin. This is pretty good. Put 0046. All right, so God, my time is almost up. I should increase my time with his video, but apparently the screencasting only give me 15 minutes, so I'm gonna have to be going soon. All right. But anyway, the top 100, you know what, on my next video, I might go over the top, from the top 100 to 200, so I can have time on my next video. But on the top 100, I don't see much other than what I mentioned that I have position in, because the rest, Ken I have, that's garbage. I think it's garbage. All right. All this other stuff, I don't have position in it. Pretty bad. But you know what, like I said, it's a lot risky, especially ones at the, with that kind of price. I'm looking for something under 10 cents. All right, anyway, until next time, guys, remember to subscribe to the Coin King channel, all right? I need more subscriber so I can continue making cool videos for you guys, all right? Until next time, peace.